Empire Diaries. I am Emmanuel Kojo Jones-Mensah. Leaving behind my friends and family, I spent 10 years in London receiving my law degree and entrepreneurial experience. Yet, as soon as I could, I made my way back home. My people are everything to me, and Ghana is truly where my legacy belongs. With God, all things are possible.
What a wonderful way to live life. He's so full of so much light, always hungry for more.
Welcome to the Empire Diaries.
It's where it all started. That's where I grew up, right there. First floor.
All right, so every Wednesday we try to bring you up close and personal with some of your favorite personalities, and this young man, you just saw a video of him, is one of such, and he's just trying so hard to put Ghana out there globally. He has so much experience in construction, in oil and gas management and real estate, think of what, and he's trying really hard to provide employment for his people. This morning, we're talking to the CEO of Empire Group, right?
That's right.
Emmanuel Kojo Jones-Mensah. Good morning. It's good to see you.
Good
welcome.
To see you.
I hope you had a restful night.
I did. Thank you.
Okay. So tell us about yourself, what you do, what inspired you to even start it in the first place.
Okay. Well, my inspiration for getting into business started from university, where a friend of mine, with myself, we started a cleaning company in London, where we used to clean construction sites. And funny enough, that's where the passion for construction and real estate started from. So as a result of that, I was engaging with a lot of developers, a lot of contractors. And I just thought to myself, wow, this is something I really want to get into. And that's how I got into the real estate market. I went ahead to start my own company in Ghana in 2014-15 with my family, Empire Concrete. And from there, we got into construction, real estate management, and that's how it started.
So all of this business inspiration came from when you were living in the UK.
That's right.
Would you say that your stay there changed your life?
Well, yes, I had a lot of exposure in the UK. And I mean, I come from a lineage of a lot of strong business entrepreneurs, so I was fortunate enough to learn from them. So some inspiration also came from my family as well. But I think the exposure into getting into business, starting to do things myself, started from the UK, yes.
So behind, aside construction, real estate, what are some of the sectors of the economy? Because you're a businessman.
That's
in the
right.
video that we saw, you seem to be interested in lots of business. What are the sectors of the economy that you're interested in?
Well, the energy sector is an area that I'm looking at very closely, because everything you see around us is subject to the fact that some power generation system is running that's given us light, which tells us the importance of energy in our sector. And if we want to have an impact in Africa, industrialize Africa, we need to start thinking of how we can be sustainable in terms of our energy supply. So I'm looking critically at that sector. I set up a trading company as well to bring in commodities, rice, sugar, and all that. So that's also another area.
How old are you again, if I may ask?
I'm old enough.
Old enough, huh, to do all of these businesses.
Yeah.
But you left Ghana about 10 years ago.
10 years ago, yes.
From when you left Ghana and now that you're back doing all of these things, do you think that as a country we have developed enough?
I think we have moved forward, yes, but there's still room for improvement.
So much more.
So much more, absolutely. So there's a lot that we need to do, and that's why entrepreneurs like myself are pushing the agenda to make sure that we create more opportunities, create more jobs, assist the government, whichever government is empowered, to attain the objectives, because, you know, entrepreneurship builds a lot of economies when you look at developed countries, and that's what we entrepreneurs need to do to support the system and try to create change.
I asked about your age, even though you failed to tell me, and I asked you because it's really hard. Well, I've heard a lot of people, young people, say that it's really hard to come up and, you know, conquer the business world. Usually the opportunities are given to the much older people.
That's true.
Do you face the same challenge?
I do, and that's one of the challenges.
Meaning you're young.
Yes. That's one of the challenges I'm facing as a young entrepreneur. a lot of people just look at you and go like, you know, he's a very young man, why is he so ambitious? But that shouldn't be the focus. The focus should be the substance that I'm bringing on board and the impact that I can have on society, and not my age or who I am. You should look at what I'm bringing on board, and that should be the focus. And I think once we're able to shift our mindset from the older generation trying to impose businesses or take advantage of businesses or get into the business sphere and transfer that knowledge and also enhance the young entrepreneurs also come up, we would start to see a positive change in things in Ghana.
Okay, in a bit we'll talk about the impact that you've had on society, i.e. in terms of providing employment and the rest. But I realized about, I was looking through your photos on social media, yeah. I realized that you went to Harvard recently.
Yeah.
Tell us about it.
Well, it was an amazing experience. I think I was surprised when I was, you know, I received the invitation to come to Harvard. But I think they were looking for young Africans in the continent doing mm-hmm. stuff and having an impact. And by the grace of God, I was recognized, and I went there to represent Ghana in terms of entrepreneurship, real estate development in Africa, and to also speak to the guys in the diaspora who are looking to come back. They wanted to understand the sort of challenges we faced when we moved back to Ghana to start our businesses, and just to give them some sort of guidance, a roadmap as to how to go about things when they're moving back into Ghana or into Africa to establish businesses, which was fantastic.
Did they sound enthused hearing your story and wanting to come back? There are lots of people outside the country who don't even want to hear the sound of Ghana.
Well, I mean, yes and no, because at the conference, I met a lot of Africans, young, you know, Africans who were very passionate about coming back to Ghana, coming back to Africa, but they were, you know, not so certain as to what to do, how to go about it. So the will and passion is there. It's just a matter of, you know, getting them into the right driving seat, give them some direction, get them inspired, let them understand that, yes, it's possible here. We can also do it here. And that's what we did in Harvard.
Okay. Now, let's come back to the country and talk about your contribution to the economy. Tell us what you are doing in terms of developing Ghanaians and the economy at large.
Well, I think I would have to attribute that to a collective effort. Mm-hmm. It's not just me. I would have to applaud my team as well for mm-hmm. making it possible. But we are focused more on creating infrastructural projects, contributing to the infrastructural development of Ghana. And that's why we set up Empire Concrete, because when you look around you, almost everything around you is concrete. That tells you the significance of concrete and infrastructural development, and our aim is to contribute so much to that in terms of road infrastructure, building infrastructure. You look at the likes of Rwanda, they're doing so well in terms of their real estate infrastructural mm-hmm. space, mm-hmm. and we want to do something similar in Ghana.
So what projects are you currently working on?
Right now we're working on, we have a hotel project that we're working on in airport. We have some townhomes in Cantonment. We have some projects in East Legon and quite a few projects.
I see. You seem to be making a lot of money at a very young age.
Well, it's by the grace of God.
Okay. Yes. Let's talk about your corporate social responsibility as part of the Empire Group. Tell us about it and what you have a foundation, don't you?
Yes, I do.
What is the focus of it?
The foundation is KJM Foundation. I think if you go online, it's www.kjmfoundation.com. I just thought we could give back to society as much as we can. Mm-hmm. We set up the foundation to focus on three areas. The first area was providing clean drinking water to less privileged societies. The second was school supplies to educational facilities. And the third was youth empowerment, which I'm very passionate about. And everyone knows that I drive that passion so much. I think that we have to give back to our society and empower the youth. Do our best to train them, help change their mindset, help them understand the dynamics of business. And if we're able to do that to today's youth, the future leaders of our country would be in a much better position to make strategic decisions that would move us forward. And that's what we're doing, and that's the focus of the foundation, is to empower the youth, give them an opportunity, give them a voice, and teach them about how to get into business, how to manage and to create wealth.
How are you doing that? I hear a lot of people talk about youth empowerment, and I try to find out from them in what ways you're empowering them.
Okay, so
how are you doing? Are you organizing meetings?
Yeah. The foundation is new. Mm-hmm. We're putting together a very interesting program that would focus on creating job opportunities for the youth and also funding opportunities, because you realize a lot of entrepreneurs in Africa, in Ghana, have funding
challenges.
Right. And we're looking at how we can bridge that gap, and that's how we're looking to get into that space of empowering entrepreneurs and young people in Ghana. But we're also partnering with companies that are already in the process of doing young empowering young entrepreneurs. So that's what we're doing in that space. Yes.
Okay. Is it okay for us to move a little bit from work and talk about your social life?
Absolutely.
I mean, you're young. You're cute. Are you married?
No, I'm not married. No.
Are you in a relationship? I'm asking for someone
I'll tell you after.
No, she's watching, so she would want to know.
I'll tell you after the show.
What do you do when you're not working?
Well, I have a few friends that I hang out with when I'm not working. Football, tennis, very active in my sports life. So, yes, that's what I do.
Do you party a lot? Do you...
Not a lot, but once in a while I shake a leg here and there, yes, but not a lot.
I see.
Yes.
What does the next 10 years look like for Kojo Jones?
I think for me, I would like to create more opportunities, and the reason why I got into business is to create employment and have an impact in society, and I would like to be in a position to create more employment, create more opportunities for people to develop and actually have a positive impact on Ghana and Africa. That's what you should look at for Kojo Jones in 10 years.
If you weren't doing business, what other profession would you have been involved in?
You know, when I was young, I always wanted to be a soldier.
Yeah?
Yes.
Not music?
No.
No acting?
No acting, no. I always wanted to be a soldier. I just liked the discipline in the military, and that's what I wanted to do. I used to admire the fact that they were always looking sharp in their uniforms and, you know, very disciplined. And
interesting. But do you dance?
Oh, I can shake a leg.
You can dance. Yes. Well, I don't know if my director would have played a song or two to see you dance. Well, she says that she doesn't want to put you on the spot. But
okay.
A very interesting conversation, and we're looking forward to when next you're empowering the youth. Invite us.
Absolutely.
Let's see how you do it, because I'm sure there are lots of people who would like to hear your story.
Yes, I mean, we need your support as well to help push an agenda, because you have the media strength and you have that gateway to help us get to the youth and empower them and help them, you know, in their daily activities, and try to put Ghana on the map as much as we can.
Right, but how has Ghanaians accepted you? How has the reception been back?
It's been amazing.
Yeah?
It's been a very humbling experience. I've had the opportunity to meet a lot of young Ghanaians, and I think I might be doing something right for them to love me so much. So, and I thank them for pushing me. Sometimes, you know, they encourage me to keep going. You know, I keep hearing things like, you are my role model, you're someone I look up to, and that alone gives us the will and the zeal to move forward and try and do more things for them.
You won a couple of awards as well.
That's right.
Tell us about it.
Well, I won the Young Achiever of the Year from Emmy Awards, Business Executive of the Year from Glitz Africa, and International African Award Merit from one organization as well.
Wow. Yes. Congratulations.
Thank you.
We look forward to more wins.
Thank you.
In the coming years.
Thank you.
Anyway, thank you very much for coming on the show.
Thank
Emmanuel
you.
Kojo Jones-Mensah. He's the CEO of Empire Domus and Empire Concrete and a whole lot of other businesses, which I don't remember immediately. But thank you very much. And he's ever ready to empower you if you look up to him, or one of the many who look up to him. Thank you very much for coming on the show.
Thank you.
We wish you all the best.
Thank
and
you.
In the next 10 years, hopefully we'll sit down and have this conversation.
Absolutely.
Again,
look
and look back
it.
At all the things that you have achieved. Thank you very
to.
Much for watching the show. I got a number of messages that I should have asked you for questions, but I'll put them to you off air, because
okay.
Unfortunately we have to go. Thank you very much for watching the show. Stay with us. We'll be back after this with D Crime.